who can define it for me? What is the locus? How do you define locus?
Right.
What's your name? Girish. Girish, you can help Girish. Yeah, please.
A set of geometrical points.
Yeah.
A set of points having same definition.
Okay, can somebody do it better for me? A set of points that is equidistant from a particular point. What is that? What is that? That is an example of a locus. What is it? What does it give you?
So that is
an illustration.
Set of points
in a line.
A set of points that follow a condition.
Yeah. Set of points that follow a certain set of given conditions. Okay. It will be different for various things. You can, but any particular arrangement can be defined with respect to it. And circle is an example of that. What is a circle? A set of points that are equidistant from a given point. So if I take a given point and create a set of all those points in the world which are equidistant from this point, I get a circle if it is a two-dimensional plane. If I do it three-dimensional, what do I get? Okay. Here we are talking about something which is not so mathematical, but something which is about what is called as events in our life. Now, maths and life, see how closely they are related. Maths is not out of life, it's part of life. Na? We are talking about here something which is very important in your journey to get into the IITs. And there is a locus of control that exists in your life which tells me, today I can tell you how many of you have to work a little harder because of something that you have just filled up. You have not filled up yet? Okay. You take your time and do it, don't worry. Okay. This is called locus of control, and the scores that you have got, it tells you a little about yourself, okay? If it is good, don't start celebrating. If you need to do some work, don't, you know, if I say that no, the scores have to improve, don't pass a judgment that you are bad or lousy. That's not the intention of this exercise. You can assume that you have so much of maturity? Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
I am taking this particular session is, I am understanding these guys are young adults, reasonably mature, they know where they are going. And they also can handle if there is some feedback that points out to dekh is jagah par tere improve karne ka hai, so tension nahi hoga, bhag nahi jayega, theek hai na? Okay, we are talking about something called locus of control, and just understand this concept. What it says simply is, each one of us in this room, we belong to, you know, either A or B set of people. The way we think about some things in life is either we belong to set A or set B. What is the set A thing? Okay, I will call them with an acronym I. These people, you know, there are some of us in this room who think that a very small thing or a big thing in our life that happens in my life, predominantly I am responsible for it. Does it make sense? Okay. So if I belong to this group of people, and if somebody asks me, who do you think will take you to IITs? What will his response be?
I.
If you don't go to get into IIT and your uncle come and ask, "Are, to IIT kyun nahi ja paya hai? Why did you reach only REC Suratkal?" You will say, "I did not work hard. I goofed up here. I goofed up there." No, predominantly. If you come late into the class, what did he say? Did you hear what is his name? Aditya. What did Aditya say? Do you remember? He came late into the class. I asked him, "Why are you late?" What did he say? Huh? He said, "I am sorry." He did not say there was a traffic jam. Does it make sense? When somebody says, "I am sorry," he is saying, after internalizing the responsibility, and he is saying, "I am responsible for coming late. I am sorry," which is an outcome of taking responsibility. Am I making sense? There are another set of us who think, and please understand, neither is good or bad, but it helps being at one location than the other. And how to move from A to B also we will talk. And we've got 2 years of time. It's only a question of the way we think, and not to do things differently. this person, or let's just spend a minute more and understand it before we get there. The person who has got, and this person is supposed to have what is called as an internal locus of control. Make sense? So if I have an internal locus of control, I believe that whether there is a success or a failure in my life, which means if I go and win a cricket match in my neighborhood next Sunday, or I win in a dance competition, you fundamentally believe that I am predominantly responsible for this success. Okay, predominantly, not exclusively. Am I making sense? Which means parents are important, teachers are important, my friends helped me get there, but I was responsible for it. Is that what he will tell himself when he succeeds? Okay. What if he loses a cricket match, or he ends up getting only a bronze medal in the dance competition? What will he tell himself, or she tell herself? Yes, I'm still responsible. Maybe I did not practice as hard as I should have. Maybe I did not take advice from the right people. Maybe whatever that the reasons are. Okay. What does this person do? Somebody's got an external locus of control. He blames others. In case of failures, what does he do?
Yes.
They are responsible. Teacher kharab, school bekar, textbook mein errata tha. डैडी बहुत बेकार, टीवी चलाते रहते हैं, मम्मी बेकार, पड़ोसी से लड़ती रहती है, सब गड़बड़, मैं कैसा हूँ? मैं बहुत अच्छा. In case of failure, but even more important, we are not saying he always fails, he also succeeds. Might be so talented that he might just succeed, no? There are some people who have heard, IIT तो मैं गया नहीं, मैं IIM गया था, मैं बहुत मेहनत किया था, but वहाँ पर जाकर कुछ लोगों को मिला था, बोल रहे थे कि I just applied and I went for the exam. I was not expecting. I came through. I was thinking, my God, what a brilliant guy! And you will find such guys. You will meet at IITs also. You will say, I worked for 2 years from 2004 to 2006. He says, मैंने जल्दी फॉर्म ले लिया भर दिया. Either you believe him or don't believe is a different matter. But if he's actually done that, he is a brilliant guy. Okay, he's not ordinary. But in case of a success, this person who's got an external locus of control, what will he say? Matter of chance, very good. What else will he say?
Luck.
What else will he say? Destiny. Bhagwan bahut achha tha. Main har Thursday jata hu Sai Baba ka mandir. Sai Baba is great. So your nephew will come and say, I want to go to IIT. What will you tell him? Forget the second holiday, forget your order. What you must remember? Wo Sai Baba har Thursday jayega. Kahan pahunchega wo? Sai Baba mandir ke bagal mein school college hai, udhar pahunchega. So, in case of success as well as failure, does anyone of you have bank accounts? Do you have bank account? Take it. अभी नहीं है ना अभी शुरू नहीं हुआ वो ज़माना नहीं है. Joint account है किसके साथ? ठीक है. But all of you have two bank accounts. I know this. Let me tell you today. There is one bank account called. What is the bank account called? There is another bank account called. Learning goals. Okay, these are very closely linked with this. You know, the bank account that you have in the bank, which where there is money, it gets operated only twice or thrice in a month. This gets operated every day. Every day, either you operate it by conscious, or it gets operated unconsciously. Just imagine what happened to your confidence when you got a call letter. I hope I am right. When you got a call from our faculty or our counselors and they said you have done well in the IIT JEE aptitude test that we take, did you feel good or bad about it?
Good.
I met so many students who said, sir, but he's got only 47. How are you saying it is very good? Bole, we'll show you the list of students who got more than 47. In the whole lot of about 800 plus students, there are only some 49 students who got more than 47. In 800 students, he said, are you saying 47 is a good score? But when we told the parent and the child, and some of you must have got to hear this, it's a very good score because it's an aptitude test at this point in time. It tells me that the temperament to think in the way it is required for IIT is very good. So when you heard that from a sir here, or Akte sir, or Arun Roy sir, or Sanjay Padia sir, what happened to your confidence? It goes up a little bit. okay? And this goes up a little bit. If you have this kind of a internal locus of punishment, you said, "Acha, I know it is good because I have worked in the last year, 2 years, etc." So anybody who's here, if he goes through a success and you play well in that particular event, your confidence goes up. What happens if you go through an event which is a failure? How many of you say play sports? Anybody play sports? You can't play too much in the next 2 years. I saw some of you written writing it there. Okay, but you went into a match yesterday and you lost the match, and you have an internal locus of control. What do you tell yourself when you're walking back home or in the night when you're thinking about the match?
I'll win the next time.
How will you win the next time? We lost today. How can you win the next time? Scoring more, which means you're telling that I did not score as much as I should have today. What else?
Working harder.
In what? Yes, practice harder. So when you're doing that, what are you actually doing? Just try to, you know, pick up that picture and put it in this conceptual framework. You're saying, I failed in an event today, and I'm a person who has got an internal locus of control, which means I take responsibility for the simple events that take place in my life. That is all. We're not talking anything more esoteric than that. Very simple stuff. I failed, but I take responsibility. When I take responsibility, I think, I introspect, and I come out with what are the new learning goals that I want to accomplish if I want to succeed the next time. Taking the same cricket match score, here I am saying I want to score more. Somebody else said I want to practice more. Somebody else said something else. And when you think about this, you will say, how can you score more? You will say, I did not take singles if it is a cricket match. If it's a hockey match, I'll say, I think I must practice more of penalty strokes. I got a penalty stroke and I missed it. How shameful it is. Then you tell yourself, I did not practice as much as I should have. I hope I'm making sense, right? So we're talking about, if I belong here, whether it is a success or a failure, both are equally important events for me. One event helps me grow in confidence, the other one helps me grow in terms of learning. Make sense? How is it relevant to your IITJE preparation? You're going to have so many tests, every weekly test, every monthly test is an opportunity to get here or get here. But the important thing is, I need to belong here in order to benefit from these two. Okay? Let's take a look at this. What happens to this gentleman? External locus, and he succeeds. We heard what we said? Luck, chance, etc. As a result, what am I doing? Does my confidence go up? Doesn't go up. And see how criminal it is on myself. Bhai, examination mein achha kiya. सब लोग बोल रहे हैं अरे यार बहुत टैलेंट है और मैं कहता हूँ नहीं 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 ये मेरी वजह से नहीं मेरे पड़ोसी बहुत अच्छा था. टेक अ लुक एट दिस इवेंट. वेरी टैलेंटेड गॉन थ्रू एन इवेंट बट एंडेड अप एज अ फेलियर विच हैपेंस टू ऑल ऑफ अस. यू नो इवन अमिताभ बच्चन हैड अ फ्लॉप मूवीज इवन बिल गेट्स हैड अ फ्यू फ्लॉप प्रोडक्ट्स इज नो प्रॉब्लम बट व्हाट डू आई डू इन केस ऑफ अ फेलियर. I blame others. As a result, what do? I can't make others learn, can I? So the chance to get this or get this is lost. Not because the way I am, but because of only one thing. What is that thing?
Blaming others.
Yes, I do not take responsibility of my life on myself. Does it make sense? Yeah? Coming to a preparation for IIT, if there is a color television in every room in your house, you cannot blame that for not getting into IIT. If your friends are playing cricket match all around the year, or they are watching movies every day because they have so many DVDs at home, and you are his neighbor, you can't blame him. If I am a lousy teacher at Arun Roy classes, can you blame me? Now I am buying an insurance for myself. What am I telling you? You blame me as a customer. I'll be happy to take the feedback, but not as a student who wants to become big in life. You have a choice. You have a choice. What will you do? You have to come and ask for the quality that you want. How can I know in the group of 50 that all of you, what is it that you want? You know, the reason I'm asking you why you must speak more, you're otherwise leaving it to chance. You're leaving your learning to chance. When you put your hand up and ask a doubt, I know, oh, this guy wants to know this. So if I cannot cover it in the class in these 2 hours, what will I do? What will I do? I tell you, meet me after the class. I said, this is my email ID. I have given you my email ID already. If you are a guy who believes in controlling his life, taking responsibility for events in your life, what will you do? You may not meet me for the next 3 weeks, but you think, oh, this guy is worth talking to. You will send an email to arun.roy@arunroy.com and say, sir, I have a problem in physics. I could not meet you for the last 3 weeks. Can I give you a call sometime? Will he say, get out of the class?
No.
We have students calling up at 12 in the night and asking specific questions. So we need to tell him, I am in my car. Let me reach home. I will pull out that book. I don't remember it by heart. You call me back again at 12:20. I cannot do it. I will not do it for 800 students, 500 students. I will do it for those who take the initiative. Am I making sense? Yes. So I am articulating this entire thing in a very simple format for you. Getting into IIT is your job. Being a facilitator is my job. Being a facilitator is your parents' job. Being a help, you know, a guide, a little bit of motivator is your cousin's job if he's gone into IIT. But we can't do anything for you. The ball is in your court. Your responsibility, and you have to take responsibility. Okay, let us come back to your scores and see what it is. Just take a look at your scores. I'll be able to tell you with a little bit of specifics about how you can improve. Okay, what is the first column say?
I.
What is the first column?
I.
What is the second column?
Low.
Okay. Easy. What does I stand for? Any guesses?
Internal.
Very good. What is the second column? EO.
External.
Excellent. Very good. External. Others. Which means those of us who think that things outside me control some parts of my life, there are two kinds of things that control our life. One is called external. Others. What is the third one? External. Okay, and this is E. So just add up EO plus EC and you know I, and then just put down the two scores. Okay, and this is the golden equation that you must have. If you're not having it, then we need to talk. Equal, no problem, just increase it. Now that you know what to do, right? When you win the next match, what will you say? Like Ivan Patan does that, no? Any cream goes, Steve walk? Good. Right? Arey, pehla Steve walk ka tha uska. Cricket nahi dekhta ye, kaisa? IIT kaise jaye gaye? No, thermodynamics you can learn by watching somebody swing bowling, no? Thermodynamics? Jyada nahi dekhna chahiye, thoda dekhna chahiye. Okay? What is your score of I? 35. What is the maximum you can get here?
40.
Very good. What is the maximum here? What is the maximum in under EO? 40. Under EO maximum is what?
40.
Why? Are you calculating? What is the maximum? How many items are there?
10.
What is the maximum under each item?
4.
So maximum you can get is? 40 under EO. What about EC? How many? What is the maximum?
40.
Who has not spoken at all? What's your name?
Dairya.
Dairya. Dairya, what is the maximum you can score on EC?
40.
How?
Not counted.
Are maximum? 40 kaise bol diya? Koi aur bola isliye. How 40?
10.
10 into 4. Okay, very good. So we are saying max is here, max is here, max is here. What is the ideal score? What is the ideal that you must score on internal?
40.
Okay, max means so much so on the ideal. What about E?
Zero.
Ah. Kar diya na? Are we saying, so when you say it is zero, you are saying that my parents have no role to play in my life. Did we say that? Yes or no? No. When you are saying zero, you are saying my teachers have no role to play in my life. Or in the IIT JEE event. Or if you are playing a same volleyball match or a cricket match or a drama, other participants, other team members are all useless. they know, you know, whether I am there with 8 pieces of luggage as good as 8 friends. Are we saying that?
No.
Remember, we said predominantly responsible. There is some role that the parents play, obviously a lot of role, no? But who is more and who is less is what we are talking about. I am predominantly responsible, significantly responsible, not exclusively responsible. We know these words, right? Exclusive, predominant, significant, marginal, insignificant, okay? So what we are saying is, the more it is, the better it is. 30 plus is a very good score. But once I put the I, then I need to measure my E with respect to I. Okay? And when you add up EO plus EC, just ask yourself the score that I've come already, is my I more than E put together? Okay? How many of you have it like this? I greater than EO plus EC? Good, that's a large number. I'm so you know that you're on the right path, okay? But I want to talk to those of you, 4, 5, whose I is lower than E. Can I see the lines up? Yes. Okay. It is very important for you to understand that there is nothing wrong about this score. But there is just a little bit piece of information to think about. Your score is at variance from what I experienced of you when you walked into the class. No, had you said there was a traffic jam? I don't know if you said or not.
Yeah.
You said that?
I said I'm sorry, but then there was a traffic
jam. If you said there was a traffic jam, then it actually is telling me that this guy has not internally taken responsibility. Make sense? Yeah. We need to be successful in life in spite of the problems. That's what Bill Gates is all about. That's what Albert Einstein is all about. You know, these guys क्या स्ट्रीट लाइट के नीचे बत्ती के नीचे बैठ के पढ़ा था रामानुजन, नाम सुना ना इसका?
यस सर,
मैथमेटिशियन, द टेंथ इन द टेंथ क्लास बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ एट द टाइम मद्रास प्रेसिडेंसी द द एग्जामिनर फेल्ड हिम, बोला ऐसे थोड़ी करते हैं मैथ्स, बिकॉज उसने प्रिफर्ड को फॉर्मेट में नहीं किया था, ही फाउंड एन इनोवेटिव वे ऑफ डूइंग दैट पर्टिकुलर मैथ्स. ओके, विल गेट इनटू ऑल दिस बिट लिटिल लेटर अगेन, बट can I see the hands up again? People whose I is lower than E. There is something to think about, okay? You are talented, you are gifted, you have the basic aptitude, but ask yourself, do you end up doing this? Do you end up not taking responsibility in both the events as much as you should? Okay? Others are important. There is something called luck, there is something called fortune, there is something called something, it is not in your control. But can I begin to think a little differently from today is very important. Okay? Can I take more responsibility? If mom catches you and she shouts at you, why are you not studying? If you are not studying, whatever be the reason, do I take responsibility or not? Or do I say, mummy, bhaiya, baithe cricket match ka commentary sun raha tha, main bhi sunne lag gaya. Okay? Make sense? Okay? Moving on, we will maybe come back and visit this maybe 3 months from now or couple of months from now. But if anything that occurs to you, you want to talk to me, feel free to catch me outside the class or send an email and we will handle that. Can we move on? Any questions on this? Any questions? Doubts? Okay. We'll have just two small things to cover before we close. One is called all this while last hour and a half we focused on this. Okay? Remember what did I start the session with? Yeah, begin with the end in mind. Okay? Begin with the end in mind. But one of the most important things about anybody who's chasing a goal is his or her ability to enjoy the journey. No? In order to use a simpler word, I'll use the word enjoy the journey. Kitna dur hai IIT jaane ka? 2 years away. 2 years away. And while my energy comes from here, lot of enjoyment comes from this. Lot of enjoyment has to be derived out of the process of going to the journey. And just to drive home the point, if I take an analogy, कभी drive करते हुए या train में या bus में मान लीजिए यहाँ से कहीं picnic जा रहे हैं, गए होंगे ऐसे स्कूल के साथ फैमिली के साथ, एंड मेनी टाइम्स डिड यू एक्सपीरियंस योरसेल्फ गेटिंग इम्पेशेंट अबाउट रीचिंग द गोल. अरे यार लोनावाला जाना था, निकल गए बॉम्बे से, कब पहुंचेंगे, कितना जल्दी पहुंचूंगा, कितना फ्रेश पहुंचूंगा. मेनी टाइम्स दैट इज दैट प्रीऑक्यूपेशन विद द गोल इज इंपॉर्टेंट, बट व्हेन थिंग्स आर नॉट गोइंग वेरी वेल or when during the testing times, you will find that preoccupation with the goal sometimes is a little unproductive. It is very important to enjoy the process. You know, Lonawala pahunchna hai, lekin abhi gaadi chai ke liye rukaya hai, toh chai ke liye ruk gaya hai, ab kya kar sakte ho, aapke haath mein toh nahi tha, rokna tha, usne rok diya, kyunki 25 jane chai peena chahte the, aap nahi peete ho, so can I get down from the bus, take a walk, go up that, you know, that footpath, the trail of path up, you know, up onto the mountains, pick some flowers, can I enjoy the journey? That's extremely important. And the journey about getting into IIT is so rich that you must consciously try to cultivate this habit. You know, one very simple thing is called scientific temperament. You know, I picked up one book, you know, this book called Dance for Two. ये ना ये बुक का नाम सुना है, कभी सुना है? नहीं सुना है. नो दिस बुक इज रिटन बाय हु? व्हाट इज द नेम रिटन हियर? यू नो हु इज? इफ एनी ऑफ यू गोस टू, इफ एंड अप गोइंग टू एमआईटी का नाम सुना है? व्हाट इज इट? मैसाचुसेट्स इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी. इफ यू गो देयर, ही विल टीच फिजिक्स फॉर यू. एंड यू नो हाउ ग्रेट अ गाय ही इज एबल टू टीच फिजिक्स by giving examples of a ballet dancer. He will teach friction by giving analogy of a ballet dancer. By then ballet dancer is dancing, there is friction that she is encountering, hai ki nahi? See how beautiful physics can be. It's not that mundane, uninteresting, unromantic in that poorly printed Maharashtra board physics book. That's not physics. If you want to get into IIT, can you get to a place where you fall in love with this subject? And if you pick up a book like this, there is a book called, there is a particular chapter called Newton, what is it called? A Visit by Mr. Newton. He's talking about how Newton visited his office and Newton shared with him that he goofed up in, what is Newton's law, universal law of gravitation? Newton, imagine Newton coming to you and saying tomorrow at the Thane station, मैंने गलती कर दिया, वो आर स्क्वायर नहीं है, वो आर क्यूब है. देखो क्या हो जाएगा दुनिया में. Imagine somebody suddenly coming and saying that the planets don't move in circular motions, they move in elliptical orbits. Who said that? Kepler, Galileo, Newton, Einstein. Kepler. There is so much of beauty, so much of romance about science. It is not about 100 marks, and that's what getting into IIT helps you. No, the scientific temperament gets cultivated, and irrespective of the career you eventually end up with, you know, after getting into IIT, it's not necessary that you'll be preoccupied with, you know, with the deep part of science for the next 40 years. You may branch out and do applied part of engineering in some other area. You may end up doing it for a company like Boeing, in which case you have to apply the fundamentals of physics in a manufacturing location, designing an aircraft. How do you do that? You can't do it if you try to pass the exam with no love for the subject. Am I making sense? Even if you become the become a manager, the only perpetual machine ever invented by man is what? It's not in physics, it's in economics. It's called demand supply. That's the only machine that you can imagine that is in perpetual motion. Every other machine comes to a rest. The application of science and scientific temperament in economics, far away in management, very deep in R&D, very deep in manufacturing. Okay, the aerodynamically designed better cars, they are not done by a manufacturing guy, it's done by a person who understands physics, who understands aerodynamics, and then who gives it shape, size, color. Okay, so the important thing I'm coming to talk about is why you are completely and very singularly focused on IIT. The important thing to do is, can I enjoy what I am doing? Sachin Tendulkar could not have scored 70 international test hundreds if he were tense about the goal. Am I making sense or not? Well, he enjoys. Three innings fail ho gaya, koi baat nahi. The very fact that I enjoy playing cricket, he would not do anything else in the world if you take away all his things, you know. Ferrari chheen lo, Bandra ka ghar chheen lo, sab chheen lo. वो वॉलीबॉल खेलने लगेगा क्या? और विल ही कम एंड प्रिपेयर फॉर आईआईटी? नो, आई एम मेकिंग सेंस और नॉट? यू नो व्हाट यू गेट आउट इन लाइफ इज नॉट गारंटीड, बट वेदर यू एंजॉय समथिंग दैट यू आर डूइंग और नॉट इज इन योर हैंड्स. एंड फॉर एवरी सचिन तेंदुलकर वी हैव हैड 100 विनोद कांबलीज, फॉर 100 विनोद कांबलीज वी हैव गॉट 1000 अभिजीत कालेज. सक्सेस इज नॉट गारंटीड, बट ईच ऑफ दीज थ्री पीपल एंजॉय व्हाट दे आर डूइंग. They do enjoy the game called cricket, and they will do it whether he ends up at a REC Suratkal or an IIT or an MIT. The enjoying part is something that you must bring into your preparation very consciously. It will take away a lot of frustrations. You will not have too much of frustration for more than an hour if you've done badly, because you enjoy reading physics or chemistry or maths. Making sense? Yeah, please understand, I'm not saying exam is not important. That's the most important. Hence, enjoying the preparation to go to the examination is as much important as the preparation. Okay? Alright, let's move on to the last item. Any questions up till now? You want to write down the name of this book? Write it down. There are many such books. How many of you have read a book called Einstein's Dreams? Aisa kitab padha hai? Sidney Sheldon ka naam suna hai?
Yes, yes.
Sidney Sheldon ne likha hai. Okay, we come to the last part, okay? What is the time? Okay, the last part. Put your pencils away, put your pens away. Close everything. Okay? Have you heard of a saying by Albert Einstein? देखो तुमको थोड़ा ये बुढ़े बुढ़े लोगों से थोड़ा प्यार करना शुरू करना पड़ेगा. अदर देन महिमा चौधरी एंड ऐश्वर्या राय, यू स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग विद न्यूटन आइंस्टाइन. मेक इट वेरी गुड फॉर यू. सुना है पहले कभी? है Who will read it out for me? Who has not spoken in the class at all? All things are created twice. इसका मतलब क्या है? Everything is created twice. What is the first creation? When is it happening? In your mind. And when is it happening next? Actually, you know, the guy who created Taj Mahal, whoever the architect was, or Shah Jahan was, who was mind it was, and he gave that instructions to a contractor or to an architect, he would not have said अरे जरा ईट ले आओ, जरा पत्थर ले आओ, जरा सीमेंट ले आओ, जरा चलो चलो जरा वो ले आओ, क्या बोलते हैं उसको, मार्बल ले आओ, चलो लगाओ जना दा. अरे क्या करा था, अरे बहुत ताजमहल बन गया. Could that have happened? The person who created it, he created it to the last brick, to the last inch of detail in his head before he started to create it on the ground. And right now you are at that stage, and the process that will make it happen for you is not an accident, but design in your head. Can you visualize your end product, it was Taj Mahal for Shah Jahan. What is it for you?
IIT.
And you've never been to IIT. So when somebody said you went to IIT Powai, who was that? Yeah, you said, you know, you went to IIT Powai a couple of weeks ago. Why did you go there? Just to see the campus and come away with what?
Inspiration.
Come away with inspiration. Come away with very simple thing called image. I've never seen it. So if I ask you today in the next 10 minutes to close your eyes and close your eyes and visualize IIT, what building will you visualize? What trees? What lawns? That's extremely important. There is nothing that is created in this world without it being created in the minds of the creator in his head. Then he went down to doing it on the ground. Okay? This is true in the case of Shah Jahan. This is true in the case of the lady who's filming this particular class. Imagine what she did when we were taking the class. She asked him to come here and then shoot this bench like this. Then she said, you take it from there and do. I hope you saw it, at least you noticed a couple of things. What he is doing, he is not doing randomly some things. He has got the end in mind, visualizing how the end product will look like, and to get to that end he has to do this and this and this and this, and that is dictating his action for the last 2 hours. Does it make sense? Yes or no?
Yes.
If you read the autobiography of a great cricketer called Richard Hadlee, have you heard of his name?
Yes.
He talks, if you read his autobiography, he has spent one complete chapter on visualization. And he says that every single wicket that he has taken, he visualizes them in his room the previous evening, the previous night, you know, couple of days before, etc. If you heard the recent example of Rahul Dravid telling the press people, what did he say? What did he say? Yeah, he said that had I known that the match would have been over in 4 days, I would have let Tendulkar play on. The example that I was referring to was when he was batting on 13 not out the previous evening and the press people wanted to talk to him for long, he told them, I have to bat tomorrow the whole day. Please let me go now. Would he have said that without visualizing in his head? Yes or no? Or more important, would he have played the entire day had he visualized that he is playing only up till lunch? How to jada na? No, you accomplish only as much at the best as what you visualized. Very, very little that you will go beyond that. So if you want to get into IIT, this is extremely important. Okay? So what we will do is, I told you 2 things you have to do. One, I talked about the discipline, you know, putting the charts up, and if I come to you every night before you sleep. Do you remember that or no?
Yes.
What did I say? What did I say?
Huh?
Yeah, paste it on the wall. I should know what are the 3 things that I needed to do today. Before I go to bed, I go to my master timetable and check whether I have done it or not. What I have not done, I have to get into a contract with myself that I will finish it tomorrow first thing before I go and earn my breakfast or lunch or whatever. Okay, that's item number one to be done every day. Item number two is this. Okay, we will do a 5-minute visualization right here today. And if you find time, please pay a visit to IIT Powai. Just go there with your friends. You know, just gang up as 4 people. Go there. If you want somebody to receive you there, we will arrange it for you. Fortunately, you are in Bombay. IIT is half an hour away from here. Okay, on Saturday, the faculty is going to come and take a session, I think this Saturday or next Monday, is one Kunal. Kunal is from IIT Bombay. He can help you, we can help you to have somebody not throw you out. If you say, who is bahar nikal, nahi bolega. Somebody will say, achha, ye idhar hai, idhar. It will help you in visualization. It will help you in visualization. Okay? Alright, let's just do this. Let's do a 5-minute exercise. Close your eyes, okay, close your eyes and you visualize all that I am saying. If you open your eyes before I say start, you will not go to IIT. Pakka likh ke deta hu. Aankhe khola to kya hoga? IIT nahi jayega. Pakka phir to IIT dhoondna padega. NIT dhoondna padega. Okay? Alright. But on a serious note, visualize in as much rich colors as you can. All that I'm saying, I will ask you questions, what did you see? Okay? It is the mains examination in the morning of May 21st, 2006. You have already cleared the screening test some time ago. You have prepared for mains. You woke up in the morning, go for the mains examination. Mom came, she gently woke you up, said good morning. I was in a very cheerful mood, very relaxed. All that I had to do, I have done in the last 2 years. All the preparation that I had to do, I finished, closed everything 2 days ago. I have been only relaxing and visualizing a great performance for the last 2 days. So here I wake up, I go through my newspaper very casually, have my early morning milk, I get ready, my center is not too far away from my school, I arrive at the examination hall good 40 minutes before time. I am very relaxed. There is a little bit of nervous energy that I can feel. I relax a little bit more because I am able to solve some. Go on a nice long holiday with friends and cousins. And the result day arrives. On the day of the result, my mother wakes me up and tells me that I have got a very good rank. Just imagine the rank that you want. 45, less than 500, and the number, the rank that I have been living with for the last 2 years, I have beaten that rank. I get into IIT. And this is what I've been waiting for. So I get ready, I call my friends, I enjoyed the whole day. I went and thanked my teachers. Visualize the day on which you are entering IIT. This is what you wanted for the last 2 years. Visualization is such a powerful tool that if you do it every day, you know, there's this very deep scientific thing called communicating with your subconscious mind, and what you tell a subconscious mind, you end up programming it, and the subconscious mind does not believe in logic. It does what you tell it to do. But the important thing is, you must communicate it so many times to her that she must start doing the programming. If you do this every night for the next 6 months, you will come to a stage where you will find, if somebody comes and tells you, you are not good enough to get into IIT, you will find that statement disbelieving. You say, कहाँ से पागल आ गया ये? बस एक सीट अगर IIT में है ना, किसका है? And your action, your thought, your focusing of energy will be in sync with that one thought. The thought is, end goal is visualized. The film is ready in my head. I will only make it. Okay. Thank you very much. I enjoyed this session. I hope you enjoyed too.
Yes, sir.